وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول
الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد إن شاء الله تعالى today I want to start a very important series in which بإذن الله الكريم I hope to explain the reality of Salafiyyah and what Salafiyyah means, its characteristics, its attributes. And inshallah, debunk the unpopular fallacies and the erroneous ideas that are pushed against Da'wah Salafiyyah. But before I go into the sulbul mawdu', before I go into the topic at hand, I want to bring to your attentions four important and vital introduction. The first introduction is our Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Nabiullahi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He informed us, he told us that after his death, we are going to see innovation, bid'ah. We are going to see newly invented matters in the religion of Islam. He warned us about it, alayhi salatu wasalam. And he warned us about it severely. أشد التحذير. He told us to stay away from that innovation. He also told us to stay away from those innovators. عليه الصلاة والسلام. He told us and he instructed us to follow and hold on to the Qur'an and his sunnah. He also commanded us and he told us to hold on to the way of his rightly guided khulafa, Abu Bakr, Umar, Uthman, and Ali, and their companions in general, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Following the companions and adhering to their way in how they took the Quran and the Sunnah and how they implemented it in their life, how they understood it, how they acted upon it, we were instructed by Allah and his messenger to follow them in that. Allah Azza wa Jalla, he said in the Quran, وَالسَّابِقُونَ الْأَوَّلُونَ مِنَ الْمُهَاجِرِينَ وَالْأَنصَارِ وَالَّذِينَ اتَّبَعُوهُمْ بِإِحْسَانٍ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُمْ وَرَضُوا عَنْهُ. وَالسَّابِقُونَ, the forefronts, the early Ansar and the Muhajirin. Allah mentioned subhanahu wa ta'ala first the Muhajirin. The Muhajirin are the ones who migrated from Mecca to Medina. The Sahabas who migrated from Mecca to Medina, they are called the Muhajirin. They are the best of the companions. And the ones that lived in Medina, with the residents of Medina, are called the Ansar. Radiyallahu anhum. Allah Azza wa Jalla mentioned both of them. He mentioned the Muhajirin and he mentioned the Ansar. And Allah mentioned a third group of people. وَالَّذِينَ اتَّبَعُوهُمْ بِإِحْسَانِ, and those who follow them in good. We know we can't be from the Muhajirin. And we definitely know we can't be from the Ansar. We have a third option, which is to be those who follow them in good. We follow the Muhajirin. We follow the Ansar in good. When we do that, Allah Azza wa Jalla says to us, رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُمْ وَرَضُوا عَنْهُ. Allah is going to be pleased with us, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we are pleased with Allah Azza wa Jalla. That's an important point that we understand. That for Allah to be pleased with us, subhanahu wa ta'ala, we have to follow the Muhajirin and the Ansar. What is it that we follow them in? We follow them in their speech. We follow them in their actions. We also follow them in their belief, what they believed. We follow them in how they implemented the Quran and the Sunnah in their lives. Allah Azza wa Jalla told us that if we deviate from the path of the companions, that we are going to be the dwellers of the hellfire. Allah Azza wa Jalla, he said, وَمَنْ يُشَاقِقِ الرَّسُولَ مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا تَبَيَّنَ لَهُ الْهُدَى وَيَتَّبِعْ غير سبيل المؤمنين نوله ما تولى ونصله جهنم وساءت مصيرا. Allah Azza wa Jalla, he said, anyone who turns away from the path of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, min ba'di ma tabayyana lahu al-huda, after clear cut evidence comes to you, you turn away from the path of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when the evidence has been told to you and you are told what Allah and his Messenger said in this matter, you leave the Prophet's way. And you also leave the path of the believers. Ponder here, Allah didn't just say you left the Prophet's path, but you also left the path of the companions. وَيَتَّبِعْ غَيْرَ سَبِيلِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ, and you follow a path other than the path of the believers. When this ayah came down, who were the believers? You and I were not there. The believers at that time were the Sahabas ibtida'an. First of all, it was them. They were the first believers. We all enter that taba'an. And we just can't maybe fall into that. Like in the Sahaba is number one. They were the believers of that time. وَالَّذِينَ اتَّبَعُوهُمْ بِإِحْسَانٍ and وَيَتَّبِعْ غَيْرَ السَّبِيلِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ, those together. Who follow those companions in good. And those who stay away from their path. But what do? They follow them in their path. Those two ayahs, you have to bring it together. If you stay away from the path of the companions and you abandon that path, and you also abandon the path of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what will happen to you? نُوَلِّهِ مَا تَوَلَّى, whichever path you have chosen. You like the ideology of a scholar, you read his works. You like the ideology of a 21st century individual or a YouTube scholar that you saw. Over Allah and his Messenger and the Sahabas. نُوَلِّهِ مَا تَوَلَّى وَنُصْلِهِ جَهَنَّمْ وَسَاءَتْ مَصِيرًا. Jahannam is going to be that person's final abode. The last place you're going to be is in hellfire. Jahannam. Is that a place you want to be in? No. What I just mentioned, brothers and sisters, is Salafiyyah. I've just explained to you what Salafiyyah means. As-Salafiyyah is nisbatun ila salaf. You're attributing yourself to the Prophet. You are attributing yourself to the Sahabas. You're attributing yourself to the Tabi'een. You're attributing yourself to the Atba'u Tabi'een. The three noble generation, the Prophet and his time, which is the Prophet and his companions, and the Tabi'een, which is the second generation. And the third one is the Atba'u Tabi'een. You are ascribing yourself, you are attributing yourself to those three generations. That's what it is. As-Salafiyyah nisbah ila salaf. It's an attribution to the Salaf. وَهُمْ مَنْ مَضَوْا, and the Salaf are those who preceded us. They preceded us in two things. They preceded us in time and in virtue. It's not just time. And Abu Jahl preceded us in time, but not in virtue. Abu Lahab preceded us in time, but he did not precede us in virtue. So what we say is that they preceded us in time, and they also preceded us in what? In virtue. That's what the word As-Salafiyyah means. It means نِسْبَهْ إِلَى السَّلَفْ وَهُمْ مَنْ مَضَوْا السَّلَفُ الصَّالِحِ, the pious predecessors. They are the Sahaba, they are the Tabi'un, and they are the Atba'u Tabi'in. That's who they are. They are the ones that Allah mentioned in the ayah, وَالسَّابِقُونَ الْأَوَّلُونَ مِنَ الْمُهَاجِرِينَ وَالْأَنصَارِ وَالَّذِينَ اتَّبَعُوهُمْ بِإِحْسَانٍ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُمْ وَرَضُوا عَنْهُ. And we explain that verse. You're attributing yourself to those three noble generation, those three golden generation, the three generation that the Messenger mentioned in the hadith in Bukhari and Muslim. خَيْرُ النَّاسِ قَرْنِي, the best of people are my people. ثُمَّ الَّذِينَ يَلُونَهُمْ, the second generation. Prophet, he said three generations here. He said خَيْرُ النَّاسِ قَرْنِي, the best are my generation. The word in Arabic, خَيْر, means أَخْيَر, is a superlative. It's a superlative. يعني أفعل. أخير, يعني the best of people is what? خير الناس, the best of people, all people. The alif lam here is استغراقية. It means all of the people. Who's the best? خير الناس قرني, my generation. The Prophet's generation. Who's the Prophet's generation? It was his companions. Me and my companions are the best. Who's next? ثم الذين يلونهم, and those who come after. That's two. That's the تابعين. And then after that, ثُمَّ الَّذِينَ يَلُونَهُمْ, the third generation, the third ones. So it's those three generations. We call it the golden generation. We call that the noble generation. We call that the virtuous generation. We call that pious predecessors. We call them as-salaf al-salih. Since they are the best of people, yani the Prophet's generation, him and his companions, and then the tabi'in, and then the tabi'u tabi'in, we need to do two things. First of all, attribute ourselves to them. We attribute ourselves to them. We call ourselves Salafiyyun, attributing ourselves to them. Number two, we live our lives the way that they lived it. In terms of what they say, we in the religion, we say it. Whatever they did in the religion, we do it. Whatever they believed in the religion, we believe it. Every statement that we say about this religion is a statement that we've taken from these three noble generations. Every action that we do is taken from these three noble generations. And any belief that we have in our hearts regarding this religion is taken from those three noble generations. The haqq manutan bittiba'i sahabati radiyallahu anhum. The truth, wallahi, is connected in following the companions. Wallahi, the truth is connected with following the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They are a'immatu salaf. They're the head of the salaf. When we say a salaf, they're the forefront, the sahabas. وَأَنَّ الدِّينَ الْحَقِّ. And the true religion is what? مَا كَانَ عَلَيْهِ الصَّحَابَةِ. Is what the companions were upon. Radiyallahu anhum. Salafiyyah is that. تُمَثِّلُ الْإِسْلَامَ الصَّحِيحِ. Salafiyyah means, in simple terms, what does it mean? It means the pure Islam, the untampered Islam, the clean Islam. It refers to what? Al-Islam, al-ghad, al-tari, the pure, clean, untampered, untainted, unchanged Islam. كَمَا جَاءَ بِهِ النَّبِيُّ صلى الله عليه وسلم. As the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم came with it, قَبْلَ طُرُوءِ الْمُحْدَثَاتِ وَالْبِدَعِ. Before innovation and newly invented matters happened in the religion. Islam, as-salafiyyah, is a term which is a synonym of what? It's a synonym of al-Islam, al-kamil, al-sahih. Salafiyyah is a synonym. Synonym of what? It's a synonym of Islam in its purest and completest sense. It refers to Islam at its purest, most authentic, and wholesome form. Also, there are terms that are similar to Salafiyyah. There are terms similar to a Salaf, which is what? Ahlus Sunnati wal Jama'ah. أهل السنة والجماعة أهل الحق أهل الأثر أهل الحديث الطائفة المنصورة الفرقة الناجية. And other than those terms are all what? They are all a synonym of الإسلام بمفهومها الكامل الصحيح. It's a synonym of Islam at its completest, at its most authentic version. Brothers and sisters, understand this point. Nabiullah Muhammad, he came with a pure religion, straight from Allah Azza wa Jalla. Jibreel gave the Qur'an to the Prophet. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam took that Qur'an and he passed it on to us, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The sunnah is a revelation from Allah Azza wa Jalla. The messenger conveyed that to his companions. Those companions, they passed it on to the tabi'in. And those tabi'in passed it on to the atba'u tabi'in. The Sahabas passed it to the Tabi'in, and the Tabi'in passed it to the Atba'u Tabi'in, وَهَلُمَّ جَرَّ. And the list went on. That pure Islam, on the two sides there were innovations and groups that came. Tawa'if came. Firaq came. Those are the firaq that we do not want to be associated with. We are referring to that pure Islam. From the Messenger عليه الصلاة والسلام إلى يومنا هذا, till today, the Messenger told us there's always going to be a group who are upon that path. They don't turn right or left. He said, alayhi salatu wasalam, لا تزال طائفة من أمتي ظاهرين على الحق لا يضرهم من خذلهم ولا من خالفهم حتى يأتي أمر الله وهم على ذلك. أو كما قال عليه الصلاة والسلام. He said there's always going to be a group. What are they? طائفة. A group. ظاهرين على الحق. They are always apparent. They are always visible upon the truth. They don't care about what people say. لا يخافون في الله لومة لائم. What the criticism of people will say, their statement, their actions, and their belief is all taken from the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام. It is taken from the Qur'an. It's taken from the Sahabas, the تابعين, the اتباع التابعين, وهكذا. They inherited it from each other. ظاهرين على الحق لا يضرهم من خذلهم ولا من خالفهم. The one who deceives them and the one that opposes them doesn't harm them. There's a مخذلة, a group of people want to deceive them. Does that one hurt them? ولا من خالفهم, and those who oppose them will not harm them. حتى يأتي أمر الله, until the Qiyamah comes. There's going to be a group like that. Who are they? They are the Salafiyyun. They are Ahlul Sunnah. They are Ahlul Athar. They are Al-Ta'ifatul Mansura, Al-Firqatul Najiyah. Whatever name you say, it's the same as the other. Attributing yourself to Salafiyyah is attributing yourself to the Haqq. It is not attributing yourself to a sect or a group. Attributing yourself to Salafiyyah, it doesn't mean I'm attributing myself to a group. Or I'm attributing myself to a jama'ah, or a hizb, or a tanzeem. No. Attributing yourself to Salafiyyah is not attributing to a hizb, or a jama'ah, or a tanzeem. No, not at all. كَحَالِ أَسْمَاءِ الْفِرَقِ وَالْأَحْزَابِ, like you find in other groups. Other groups, their attribution is an attribution to, or an affiliation to a particular group. It is not attribution or an affiliation to the Haqq. No, it's not. Every group other than Salafiyyah, their affiliation, their attribution is to one of these two. They are either attributed to what? إلى مؤسسيها أو إلى الأسماء التي أحدثتها مؤسسوها. They are either attributed to a person who started the group, like the Jahmiyyah. The Jahmiyyah are named after what? They are named after Jahm ibn Safwan. Like the Asha'ira, they are named after who? Abi al-Hasan al-Ash'ari. They are named after a person who came way after the Sahabas and Tabi'in and the Tabi'u Tabi'in. Or after all of that. Or they are attributed to a false notion that they believe in. A misguided concept that they believe in, they are attributed to that. Like the Qadariyyah, the Khawarij. They are attributed to what? They are attributed to their deviated belief. The Khawarij, لأنهم خرجوا, they exited, they left. Who did they leave? The Sahabas. They left the Muslim body. And the Qadariyyah, because they went against Ahlul Sunnah in the issue of Qadr. So they were called Qadariyyah. As-Salafiyyah, they are not being attributed to a particular individual. And no, they are not in any way, shape or form attributed to what? They are not attributed to a newly invented ideology that they came with. Neither of those two. They are attributed to إلى الحق. They are attributed to the truth. They are attributed to what? The three golden generation that the Prophet told us are the best of people. If someone calls himself a Salafi, should we accept that from them? Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah, he said, لا عيب على من أظهر مذهب السلف وانتسب إليه واعتزى إليه بل يجب قبول ذلك منه باتفاق فإن مذهب السلف لا يكون إلا حقا. In the fourth volume, 49, Ibn Taymiyyah, and it is Majmu' al-Fatawa, there is no blame on a person who claims, who attributes himself to the madhab of the Salaf, who comes out and says, I'm على مذهب السلف الصالح. There's no blame on that person. What he's doing is very good. وانتسب إليه, and attributes himself to it. You see, وعتزى إليه بل يجب قبول ذلك منه بالاتفاق فإن مذهب السلف لا يكون إلا حقا. It is obligatory to accept that from him. By unanimous agreement, we accept that from him. If he says, I am Salafi, we accept it from him. Then the Salafi is not a group. You don't have to have a membership card, or you don't have to file an application form and wait for the approval. It's none of that. A person comes up to us and says, أنا على مذهب السلف الصالح we accept it from them straight away. We accept it from the person. This is by unanimous agreement. فَإِنَّ مَذْهَبَ السَّلَفِ لَا يَكُونُ إِلَّا حَقًّا. Because the madhab of the Salaf is nothing except the truth. Ibn Taymiyyah says this. And the base and evidence for the statement of Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah, and the base and the evidence for the statement of Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah is قَوْلُهُ تَعَالَى وَأَنَّ هَذَا صِرَاطِي مُسْتَقِيمًا فَاتَّبِعُوهُ وَلَا تَتَّبِعُوا السُّبُلَ فَتَفَرَّقَ بِكُمْ عَنْ سَبِيلِهِ ذَلِكُمْ وَصَّاكُمْ بِهِ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, وَأَنَّ هَذَا صِرَاطِي, that's my path. فَاتَّبِعُوهُ, follow my path. وَلَا تَتَّبِعُوا السُّبُلَ, do not follow these other paths. Follow my path. The Prophet saying, وَأَنَّ هَذَا صِرَاطِي, this is my path. يعني the path of Allah. Follow the path of Allah Azza wa Jalla. يعني follow the path of the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم. وَلَا تَتَّبِعُوا السُّبُلَ, and do not follow the other path, the deviated paths. So there are other paths. There are other paths. وَلَا تَتَّبِعُوا السُّبُلَ فَتَفَرَّقَ بِكُمْ عَنْ سَبِيلِهِ, it will take you away from the straight path. ذَلِكُمْ وَصَّاكُمْ بِهِ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. This ayah, Abdullah ibn Mas'ud رضي الله تعالى عنه, he mentioned, he said, خَطَّ لَنَا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ عَلَى الْأَرْضِ خَطَّى. The Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, he made a line on the road, on the earth. And he took a twig عليه الصلاة والسلام, and he made a line on the earth. ثُمَّ خَطَّ خُطُوطًا عَنْ يَمِينِي وَعَنْ شِمَالِي. And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he made lines on the left and on the right. Nabiullah Muhammad, after he recited this verse for them, he wants to explain it to them. He wants them to really understand what this ayah is saying. And this is what they say in English: a picture draws more than 1,000 words. He wants them to truly understand, take this information in, because it's a big matter. The division of the ummah, the disunity of the ummah, the firaq and the groups coming out in Islam. And the Prophet wants his sahabas to be upon clarity. He said to them, he took a twig, he made a path on the earth, and then he made paths on the right and on the left, alayhi salatu wasalam. Then the Prophet alayhi salam said, هذا سبيل الله, this is the path of Allah. The middle path, the straight path, is Allah's path. This is the path that's going to take you to Jannah. Then the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasalam, he said, on the left and on the right there are paths. On every single one of those paths, there's a shaytan calling the people to it. There's a da'i on the top of that path, on YouTube, calling you to that hellfire. He's calling you to that misguidance. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam instructed his companions and us to follow that straight path. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. How much more do you want the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to explain it to you? What more clarity do you need? If that's not going to make matters clear for you, that you are at a time of great fitan, disunity, quarrels, argumentations, disputations, you need to focus on what is that straight path. Also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, وَاعْتَصِمُوا بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا وَلَا تَفَرَّقُوا. Hold on to the rope of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and do not become disunited. Can you not see the ayah, brothers and sisters? The way Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, hold on to the rope of Allah first before he said, don't be disunited. The unity will only come about when? It will only come when we hold on to the rope of Allah. By holding on to the rope of Allah, we will unite. But if you say, I'm going to use my logic, and Ahmed says he's going to use his logic, and I say I'm going to use my logic, and Zayd said he's going to use his logic, and Khalid says he's going to use his logic, and Bakr says he's going to use his logic, all of us have our difference in thinking. Our logics is not the same. So whose rationality are we going to come back to? Whose rationale are we going to use as a reference point? Everyone has a thinking process is different from the other. Everyone perceives things in different ways. The Qur'an and the Sunnah is judging us. That's the hakam that we go back to. وَمَا اخْتَلَفْتُمْ فِيهِ مِنْ شَيْءٍ فَحُكْمُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ. You do not dispute one another in a matter, except that the ruling is taken back to the Qur'an and the Sunnah. فَإِنْ تَنَازَعْتُمْ فِيهِ شَيْءٍ فَرُدُّوهُ إِلَى اللَّهِ وَالرَّسُولِ إِنْ كُنْتُمْ تُؤْمِنُونَ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ. If you truly believe, wallahi, everything you dispute in, take it back to the Qur'an and the Sunnah. Your answers for your problems, you'll find it in the Qur'an and the Sunnah. It's right there in front of you. Also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said in the Qur'an, إِنَّ الدِّينَ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ الْإِسْلَامِ. The religion Allah accepts is Islam. And what did I say before? السَّلَفِيَّ بِمَفْهُومِهَا الْعَامِ. سَلَفِيَّ, what does it mean? It means, as-salafiyyah means what? Al-Islam bimafhumiha al-kamil as-sahih. Salafiyyah is what? Is Islam at its whole, complete, authentic version. That's what Salafiyyah is. So, إِنَّ الدِّينَ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ الْإِسْلَامِ. Allah also says in the Qur'an, وَمَا أَتَاكُمُ الرَّسُولُ فَخُذُوهُ وَمَا نَهَاكُمْ عَنْهُ فَانْتَهُ. Anything that the Prophet ﷺ gives to you, take from it. And anything he prohibits you from, stay away from. Stay away from it. Allah also says in the Qur'an, وَإِن تُطِيعُوهُ تَهْتَدُوا. If you obey him, and if you obey Nabi like Muhammad, you will be guided. Allah also says in another ayah, اتَّبِعُوا مَا أُنزِلَ إِلَيْكُم مِّن رَبِّكُمْ وَلَا تَتَّبِعُوا مِن دُونِهِ أَوْلِيَاءَ قَلِيلًا مَا تَذَكَّرُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, follow. اتَّبِعُوا مَا أُنزِلَ إِلَيْكُمْ. Follow the Qur'an that has come down onto you. The sunnah. Follow the athar that have come from the sahabas. Follow them. And their unanimous agreement. Follow that. وَلَا تَتَّبِعُوا مِن دُونِهِ أَوْلِيَاءَ. Don't follow particular individuals. Don't follow a particular individual that opposed the Qur'an and the sunnah in a matter. However that, how high that person may be and how noble that person may be, don't. Follow the revelation. Allah also says in the Quran, ثُمَّ جَعَلْنَاكَ عَلَى شَرِيعَةٍ مِنَ الْأَمْرِ فَاتَّبِعْهَا وَلَا تَتَّبِعْ أَهْوَاءَ الَّذِينَ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ إِنَّهُمْ لَنْ يُغْنُوا عَنْكَ مِنَ اللَّهِ شَيْئًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, ثُمَّ جَعَلْنَاكَ عَلَى شَرِيعَةٍ مِنَ الْأَمْرِ فَاتَّبِعْهَا وَلَا تَتَّبِعْ أَهْوَاءَ الَّذِينَ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. We have made you, Muhammad, upon a legislation. We have set a path for you. We have given you a religion. فَاتَّبِعْهَا, follow it. وَلَا تَتَّبِعْ أَهْوَاءَ الَّذِينَ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. Do not follow the paths of those who don't know. Anyone who goes against the sharia is from مِنَ الَّذِينَ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. It's from the people who don't know. It's the sharia or it's misguidance. Salafiyyah, it resembles following the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, surrendering to what he commanded us, salawatullahi wa salamun alayhi, following his tabi'een, yani the sahabas, those who followed him, following the sahaba, radiyallahu anhum, fi umuri ddini kulliha, ilmiyiha wa amaliyiha, following the sahabas in what? In all of the religion, whether it be issues of aqidah or issues of fiqh, we follow them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he connected the truth following the companions and their methodology, radiyallahu anhum, and to tread on their path, wassayri ala tariqihim, wassayri ala tariqihim, and to follow their path. Wa ujaba, Allah made it obligatory on us, akhdha ad-deen minhum talaqiyan wa fahma, that we take the transmission of the religion that they've transmitted to us, we take that from them. Whatever they've transmitted, we accept it from them. وَفَهْمًا, and we understand the religion the way that they understood it. فَكَمَا أَنَّنَا نَتَلَقَّى عَنْهُمْ نُصُوصَ الْوَحْيَيْنِ فَكَذَلِكَ نَتَلَقَّى عَنْهُمْ فَهْمَهُمَا وَالْعَمَلَ بِهِمَا. The way that we take the Qur'an from them, we say Abu Bakr transmitted this Qur'an to us, and Umar and Uthman and the Sahabas, we also take their understanding on these verses. How is it possible that you take their transmission, but you don't take their understanding? We take both of it from them. Radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. Allah says in the Quran, فَإِنْ آمَنُوا بِمِثْلِ مَا آمَنْتُمْ بِهِ فَقَدْ اِهْتَدَوْا. If you believe in Allah Azza wa Jalla, the way that they believed in Allah, then you will be truly guided. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said in a hadith, this hadith, 16 companions narrated it from the Prophet. 16 companions. This hadith has reached haddu tawatur, multitude narration, mass transmission. It is a famous hadith known as hadithul iftiraq. It is famously known as hadithul iftiraq. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, سَتَفْتَرِقُ أُمَّتِي عَلَى 73 فِرْقَةٍ. My ummah are going to be divided into 73 groups. كلها في النار إلا واحدة. All of them are going to be in the hellfire except one. 72 of the groups are going to be in the hellfire, and one group is going to make it to Jannah. The Sahabas, they said, من هي يا رسول الله? What is that one group that's going to be saved? Who are they? The Prophet said, الجماعة, the group. Who were the group that was alive at that time? Sahaba to Rasulullah only. They were the group. They were the jama'ah that day. The Prophet said, the people are going to be saved are the jama'ah, the group, sahabas. In another narration, the Prophet told us, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who are they? He said, ma ana alayhi wa ashabi. Anyone who is upon that which me and my companions are upon. So if you want to be from the saved group, you have to be upon whose path? The path of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You also have to be on the path of his companions. That is what salvation is. This hadith, hadith al-iftiraq, it tells us that the ummah are going to be divided into how many groups? 73 groups. 72 are going to be in the hellfire, and 72 are going to be in the hellfire, and one group is going to be in Jannah. This hadith, hadith al-iftiraq, my aim and objective is to, inshallah ta'ala, speak about it in great details. I'm going to be making a series, inshallah ta'ala, where I will be speaking about usulul firaq al-dallah, the foundations of the misguided groups. As-silsila, inshallah ta'ala. But all of the groups that deviated from that straight path of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, go back to five. All of the groups, till today, ila yawmina hadha, who opposed the path of the Prophet and his companions and the tabi'in and the tabi'u tabi'in, are five groups. And this is the order that they were in. The first group are the Khawarij. The second group are the Rawafid, Rafidah. The third group is the Qadariyya. The fourth group is the Murji'a. And the fifth group is the Sufiyyah. All of the groups that deviated, they go back to one of those five. Inshallah ta'ala. If I live on, I'm going to explain this hadith by going through these five firaq, these five groups, and I'm going to be speaking about them, inshallah ta'ala, in two ways. The historical side and how they came about, and I'm also going to be speaking about their aqeed and what they believed. Inshallah ta'ala. But in this series, I will not be speaking about it. But this hadith showed us that the ummah is going to be divided into 73. 72 are going to be in the hellfire, and only one group is going to make it through. Who is that one group that's going to make it through? The Prophet ﷺ didn't say fulan, and fulan, and fulan, and fulan. He didn't. He connected it to a description that you and I can come with, which is what? Ma ana alayhi wa ashabi. Anyone who is upon that which me and my companions are upon. If you follow the Prophet's path and the companion's path, then you are from the saved sect. You can live in Timbuktu, you can live in China, you can live in Toronto, you can live in London, you can live in Paris, you can live in Istanbul, you can live in Addis Ababa, it doesn't matter. That's the description that's needed from you. Ma ana alayhi wa ashabi, whatever me and my companions were upon, you are a Salafi. Whether you call yourself it or not, it doesn't matter. That's what it is. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam emphasized on this particular point more, and this is going to be the last hadith for this series. This is going to be the last hadith for today's episode, is hadith of Irbad ibn Sariyah, where he said, the Prophet said, innahu man ya'ish minkum, whoever from amongst you is alive, who lives, fasayara ikhtilafan kathira, he's going to see a lot of argumentations. If you live on after me, you are going to see a lot of khilaf, a lot of difference of opinions. The Prophet then told his companions, he won't just tell them a problem and not tell them the solution. That's not the way of the Prophet ﷺ. Abadan. There's a problem, he tells them the solution. What did he say to them? He said, alaykum bi sunnati. Hold on to my sunnah. And the sunnah of the rightly guided khulafa, alaykum bi sunnati. وَسُنَّةِ الْخُلَفَاءِ الرَّاشِدِينَ الْمَهْدِيِّينَ عَضُّوا عَلَيْهَا بِالنَّوَاجِدِ وَإِيَّاكُمْ وَمُحْدَثَاتِ الْأُمُورِ. The Prophet said, hold on to my sunnah and the sunnah of my rightly guided khulafa. The Prophet didn't just say, hold on to my path. He didn't. He said, hold on to the path of my noble companions, Abu Bakr, Umar, Uthman, and Ali. Then the Prophet told us something else, which is the opposite of the path of he and his companions. There's a path opposite to it. What is that called? It's called bid'ah. إِيَّاكُمْ وَمُحْدَثَاتِ الْأُمُورِ. Stay away from that. the newly invented matters, the innovations that are going to be brought into the religion. Stay away from that. Stay away from that. إِيَّاكُمْ مُحْدِثَاتِ الْأُمُورِ. How can we stay away from it? The hadith itself told us how to stay away from it, which is what? تَمَسَّكُوا بِهَا وَعَضُّوا عَلَيْهَا بِالنَّوَاجِبِ. Hold on to the sunnah of the Prophet and the sunnah of the rightly guided khulafa. Hold on to it with your molar teeth. If you hold on to it softly, you're going to give in to the innovation. Don't. Hold on to it. Hard, strong, don't compromise. Don't compromise. The Prophet told us, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, سَيَأْتِي عَلَى النَّأْسِ زَمَانٌ أَلْمُتَمَسِّكُ بِدِينِي كَالْقَابِضُ عَلَى الْجَمْرَةِ. There's going to come a time, the one who's holding on to his religion, who doesn't want to let go, it's like he's holding a hot charcoal. He's holding it, but he's burning. He wants to let go. But if he lets go, he's let go of his religion. But he can't hold on to it because it's burning him. Because everybody's insulting him. Everybody's calling him names. He's considered to be an extremist. He's this, he's that. There will come a time like that. But brothers, hold on to your deen. Don't, in any way, shape or form, turn away from that way. Inshallah ta'ala, I'm going to stop there for today's episode. Bi'idhnillahi al-Kareem. Anything I might have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me and shaytan, and Allah and His Messenger are free from it. Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdika. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.
Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. How can you do a 2-second action right now that will give you a share of the reward of everything we're doing on this YouTube channel? Simple. Like this video and click subscribe. Why? It will allow YouTube to recommend our videos to other users. And imagine the huge amount of reward that could be waiting for you on the Day of Judgment if you did that with a sincere intention of spreading the Deen of Allah. You'll be rewarded for every single person who benefits from one of our videos as a result of your like or subscribe. That's an easy 2-second action that you definitely don't want to miss out on. Do it now. Click like and subscribe, and don't forget to make that intention.